Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to tell you the ways to put JavaScript to HTML. Actually, we have three ways. We have the way to do it externally. We can embed the script to HTML, or we can simply use inline script in the opening tag of an element. Now, let us look at the file structure of my HTML file as well as the JavaScript file. So we can see that I have a folder called add JavaScript, shown here. And inside this folder, I have an HTML file. And at the same level of this HTML file, I have a folder called JS. And inside this file folder, I have a file called myscript.js. And my intention is simply to add the JS file to the HTML file so that the JavaScript part of my web page can be shown properly. So let me show you the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. Okay, I just have a title, which is this one, on the tag of my web page. And then I have a body, and the body is simply containing one header, shown here, okay? And after that, I'm going to add my JavaScript file to the HTML file. So let me go to the JavaScript file first. Okay, so this is the content for the JavaScript file for now. And now I just put some comments onto the file. And we can simply learn from these comments. So for now, I'm going to show you the way to put multi-line comments. So for multi-line comments, we simply use a forward slash followed by an asterisk to enclose the content, followed by an asterisk and a forward slash to close the content. So these three lines are contained inside the multi-line comments. And I'm going to show you the major idea of this comment. We usually would use the strict mode for JavaScript, so that the code errors that were ignored by the older conventions of JavaScript programming will throw some exceptions. And in order to apply the strict mode properly, it is better to declare the strict mode globally so that we simply put the strict mode instruction at the very beginning of your JavaScript file. And I'm going to put the strict mode instruction here. Okay, use strict, enclosed by the double quotation marks, and we have to include the semicolon at the end of this instruction. Okay, here I would like to say something about the single line comment. When we use two forward slashes, we are simply setting up a single line comment. So this comment will just last for one line only. And what am I going to do for the rest of my JavaScript file? I'm going to set up an alert window. Okay, I say alert. Here shows an alert, semicolon at the end. Usually, when we want to end a statement, we have to include a semicolon so that the web browser can help us generate the content correctly. If you miss the semicolon, it is possible that the result will be different for different versions of your browser. Okay. So for this one, I'm going to show an alert window when I simply want to run this instruction. So let me save it. And then this is the end of my JavaScript file. So how can I simply include this JavaScript file to the HTML file? We have a number of ways to do so. So let me go back to the HTML file first. Okay, before we talk about the way to include the JavaScript file, we have to make sure something. We have to notice that, the JavaScript content will be executed following the code order. So when you put the JavaScript instruction later in the body of your web page, you won't waste too much time on loading the JavaScript file before you want to load the content of your HTML elements. So it is best to put the script closer to the end of the body so that you can load some elements a bit quicker before you want to really run your JavaScript file. And the first thing to discuss is the way to link the external JavaScript file. So when we go back to the directory, we can see that the JavaScript file is a separate file that is external to the HTML file. In order to simply link the external JavaScript file, I can have some idea like this one. Okay, I simply include this script element, and the opening tag of the script element is simply the location of your JavaScript file. So src means source. Source equals the location of your JavaScript file. Okay, so this is the way of linking the external JavaScript file to your HTML file. So let me save it first. Okay, so then I simply load the page. You can see that I'm able to show the alert window set up in the JavaScript file. Okay, this is the first way of loading the JavaScript file. And I'm going to show you another way of loading the JavaScript file, which is done inside the head element of your web page. So let me go to the head, and I simply do the script element in the same way as I did inside the body. Okay, so what's the meaning of putting the script element inside the head? When we do so, we will simply load the JavaScript content first before displaying any of the elements. So every single element will not show up immediately before loading the script content. Okay, so the head content will be executed first. In this case, the body content will not be shown immediately until the head part is executed. So it depends on your intention of using the JavaScript. If you really want to load all the JavaScript content just before you put the elements on the web page, you can do the addition in the head part. Okay, so let me save it and run it by reloading the page. Okay, you can still see the alert window, which is contributed by the script element inside the head part of your web page. Okay, in addition to using the external JavaScript file, I can simply do the scripting inside the body of your HTML file. So how can I do that? I can do something like this one. Okay, I simply say the alert window to be shown inside the body of the HTML file. So I begin the script content with the script opening tag, and I close it with the script closing tag. So when I save it and reload the web page, you can see that the alert window can be executed, embedded script being run, which is simply referring to the alert window that I typed in the body part of the HTML file. Okay, this is called the embedding action of your script to the HTML file. And after that, I'm going to show one more way of adding JavaScript code in your HTML file, which is known as the inline JavaScript code in the opening tag. So what does it mean by the inline JavaScript? Let me show you an example. Okay, I set up a button which has an instruction shown in the opening tag of the button element. Okay, so on click equals alert inline alert being run. So when I set up the web page that contains a click button, I'm just able to run the instructions shown in the on click part of the button opening tag. So let me save it first. Okay, the click button is shown up here. So when I simply click on this button, I'm able to run the content indicated by the opening tag of the button element. So this part is the JavaScript code that helps me to generate an alert window. Okay, so when I click on the button, I'm able to see the content saying that the inline alert is being run. So this is the alert window, and the content of the alert window is also shown up here. So this is the third way of doing the JavaScript inclusion into the HTML file, which is known as the inline JavaScript mode in the opening tag. Okay. So this video has already discussed a lot of ways to put your JavaScript code into the HTML file. The first one is simply the linking to the external file directly inside the body or inside the head part. The second one is simply the embedding of the script directly to the HTML file. And finally, we can do the inline JavaScript code in the opening tag. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.